Tea Crew, Mona B here. So before we get into the video, make sure you're turning on your post notifications so you are notified whenever I post a new video on this channel. And make sure you guys are following my vlog channel. Subscribe to my vlog channel. I am doing Vlogmas, so definitely go over there and catch up on Vlogmas. And while you're at it, follow me on Instagram at MonaXBanks. So now that we got the spill over, we can address the elephant in the room. And yes, I cut my hair again. So I cut my dye off. So that's basically what this video is going to be about. And I cut my hair myself at home. So I'm going to be telling you guys about my experience. And you guys will also see it in the later clips of this video. But I wanted to come and just give you guys some information before you watch that. I just didn't want to post that. And then you guys are like, what the heck? So yes. Here's my ball of hair. So as you guys know, my hair was teal. I dyed it blue and then it faded to teal. So this is the hair that I cut off. I went to Target today, and if you watch the vlog, you will see all of the behind the scenes on the vlog. So go over there and watch my Vlogmas vlog on the Mona Banks channel. So I went and I bought some clippers. These clippers are called Wahl. I guess that's how you pronounce it, like the wall, but it's spelled W-A-H-L. So these are the clippers that I went and bought. I got them at the men's section in Target. So if you're looking for clippers, they were originally, I think, $25 or something like that. And I got them for $21 on sale. So they come with, like, you know, the different guards and everything like that. They come with scissors, combs, oil, everything you need to maintain your clippers. So I went ahead and bought those. So I am definitely not experienced with cutting hair, but I do watch Beauty Cut Right, and I made sure I went to her videos because she cuts hair here on YouTube. Like, I don't know, I'm pretty sure y'all know who she is. Like, she always has a tapered haircut, and her haircuts always look so bomb, but she does them herself at home. So I was like, let me go look at one of her videos. She can show me what I need to know. I mean, of course, I'm not gonna be able to do it as good as she did it, but I was like, I just need to know some basics. So that's what I went ahead and did, and I went ahead and cut the color off of my head. Now, I wasn't able to cut all of the color out, obviously, because I would have had to go a lot lower, and I was nervous about cutting my whole head low. That's not something that I wanted to do on my own. So I was like, let me just cut off as much color as I could do. And I wanted to cut the top of my hair lower to match like the size of my hair. I am growing in the size of my hair, but I wanted it all to match the same length because I want to grow in my hair just a tad bit, and I want all the lengths to be the same. So I was originally gonna go ahead and do the whole tapered look with the hair long at the top, but I changed my mind because I like convenience, and when you have two different lengths of hair, you have to work with it, and I just really didn't want to deal with it, to be honest. So I was like, I'm just gonna chop the top off, and that's what I did. So of course, with me chopping the top off, I was gonna have to go ahead and get rid of my color, which is fine. Since I only really cut the top off, there was still some color left over because, like I said, I wasn't comfortable with completely cutting all of the color out. I just wanted to cut the top of my hair off, but I knew that my roots had pretty much grown in enough to where I would be able to cut it, and the color won't be all the way to the roots and looking all crazy. But of course, in some spots of my hair were longer than others, so that means some of the color I had to leave it behind, and some of the spots in my hair were shorter than others, so there was still some color left over. So when I went to the hair store today, this lady that works in there, she recommended the Via Natural Semi-Permanent Hair Color. And I use 1.5 bottles because you want to make sure your hair is saturated. These bottles, and I use the color dark brown. So I did put a rinse on my hair just to hide the extra teal that was left over. It wasn't a whole lot, but like I said, I didn't want to have like some teal here, black here. Like, no. So that's what I did. So I know for a fact that my hair is still kind of uneven because obviously I'm not a professional at this. I did the best that I could. And I only showed you guys me cutting the top of my head. But long story short, I did the best that I could. And I think for my first time cutting my own hair, I did a pretty good job. And then I went ahead and sponged it, but I really don't like that sponge. I do not recommend it. So I'm going to be going to AutoZone and getting me a sponge to make my own. I just didn't want to do all that ripping and running today. But yeah, so that is pretty much it, guys. I cut off my color because I didn't want to do the tapered look, and obviously I'm probably not gonna go to the barbershop for like another month. I'll probably wait till like the end of December, and I'll go and pick it all out and let them even it all out. But I just wanted to do it myself really quick. I always wanted to try to cut my own hair, so this was a perfect time to do it. And of course, I'm still gonna wear like slick backs and things like that. But yeah, I cut the color out, and I know someone is going to ask, will I dye my hair in the future? Yes, it's just not right now because I don't want to put the bleach on my scalp again. I actually want to wait till my hair grows out a little bit more, and then I'm going to just dye like the tips of my hair. So that's what I plan on doing. So yeah, this is my hair. That's it. I did it myself. So I know you guys are like, girl, stop talking. We just want to see how you did it. So we're just going to go ahead and get into that portion of the video. Alright, y'all, so we're gonna jump right in. As you guys can see, this is my fro, and I'm just taking my pick and picking it out to make sure there are no tangles or anything in my head. So next I'm gonna take the clippers and I put a number 3 guard on. Y'all, this is my first time ever even holding clippers in my hand, so I was so nervous. As y'all can see, look at my face. So I started to go in with the guard on it with the number 3, but it wasn't really cutting anything. Like I told you guys, I don't know a whole lot about clippers. This is my first time holding clippers, so do not try to like chump me off in the comments, okay? So I did eventually switch the guard or whatever, but yeah, I switched the hair. I switched it to a 1, I believe. And look at me, I'm so shocked that the hair is actually coming off. But from what I watched on YouTube, I know you're supposed to go backwards at the top of your head. So I was just trying to make sure I didn't have no bald spots. If it's a little uneven, I didn't even care. But I was just trying to cut majority of the top off to match the size of my head. But I am an amateur, okay? I'm so done. Y'all see I went too far down. I almost made a bald patch, but hey, you know, I'm trying, I'm learning, okay? I'm gonna get better. All right, I'm gonna get better. Y'all never know, I might be opening up a barbershop. All right, so I just kept going, you know, backwards or whatever from what I've seen people do at the barbershop and on YouTube, you know. So that's what I'm doing here. I am still shocked at the fact that I cut my own hair, y'all. Like, I just think it's the funniest thing ever. That's just how I am. Like, if I want to do something and I don't want to wait on somebody to do it, I'll try to do it myself. And I mean, it was just hair. So if I would have messed up, I would have just been shaved and bald. I mean, you know, you got to do what you got to do. So y'all see what I mean when I was saying there was going to be some of the teal hair left behind. But I'm just picking up my hair to see, like, what are the spots I missed and what I need to touch up. But I did cut, you know, the rest of my hair off camera, of course, because it's hard to cut your hair sitting down. Yeah, and I didn't have any space to really stand up. I do say so myself, I feel like I did a really good job for my first time. Look how round my little fro looks. Okay, don't play with me. I mean, it's a little uneven, but hey, it worked. So then I'm just taking my cutting shears and just touching up some spots that I missed. And then I did go ahead and wash my hair, and I'm just gonna add petroleum jelly around my hairline because now I need to dye my hair because I still had some teal spots left behind and I wasn't comfortable with cutting my hair that low on my own. So I'm just gonna take the hair color and I'm gonna put it all over my head. It is in the color dark brown. This is so funny. This is my first time ever rinsing my hair a dark color ever in life. So yeah, and I did use 1.5 bottles because I wanted to make sure my hair was really saturated. And then I'm just gonna put a plastic cap on my head, and I let that sit for about 1 hour and I rinsed it out. And now I'm just gonna apply some leave-in conditioner, and look at how dark it got. Like, I was so surprised. My hair has never been this dark. And I'm just adding some castor oil onto my head to help my scalp. And then I'm gonna apply a little EcoStyler gel and use this sponge that I do not recommend. So this part is like blah, cause it definitely didn't give me the definition that I wanted, but whatever, it's okay. And this is my hair from all angles. I think it turned out great for my first time. So I wanna thank you all for watching this video. I hope it was helpful, and I will see you all on my next one. Bye.